two strong programs go at it tonight. East Mississippi ranked number 7 and Gulf Coast number 5. Two Titan programs over the years, from coaches to players, and now they meet again on the field. Last year, they played for the MACJC Championship, and the Lions were victorious. Tonight, they open up the season here in Perkinston. A preeminent night for football in Perkinston, just north of Biloxi. On the kickoff, a pooch kick fumbled, and the Bulldogs fall on it and get the game's first break on the very first play of the game. And the Bulldog offense goes to work. Clayton Moore, double reverse. Javon Bell, 43-yard pass play reception all the way down to the 1-yard line, and the Bulldogs are in business. Two plays later, Moore punches it in from 1 yard out, and just a minute 20 into the game, the Bulldogs are on the board. The two-point conversion pass attempt fails. Brad Henderson now moving the Lion offense, gets him into the red zone, but Will Copeland steps in, intercepts the pass, thwarting the drive, and Copeland with a nice return to give the Bulldogs the football back and pick up another turnover. The Bulldogs, after the interception, methodically march 13 plays downfield, and they cap it off on Eric Wills' 2-yard run. Extra point no good, and the Bulldogs are up 12-0, and you're thinking, uh-oh, this might be a game in which the Bulldogs pull away. But don't count on it. Here comes East Mississippi. Starkville's Henderson hits sophomore receiver Marcus McQuarley out of Meridian on a 36-yard scoring pass with 10.5 to go in the quarter. And East Mississippi is on the board with their first touchdown. Then Taylor Walker of Brandon follows that up with a 31-yard field goal. And with 3:16 left in the half, the deficit to East Mississippi now is 12-10. Now the Bulldogs get the football back late first half, and they move 7 plays, 63 yards, and cap it off right here. Clayton Moore's 1-yard scoring pass to Kennedy Helms. That, the final score of the opening half, and put the Bulldogs ahead 19-10 at the break. East Mississippi now trailing 26-10 in the third quarter. Got to get going, and they do. Henderson hooks up with Rodney Davis for 34 yards on this nice gutty reception run, setting up sophomore Floyd Graves, who caps off the drive, 15-yard scoring burst right down Broadway to make it a one-score contest after the two-point conversion at 26-18. Now, midway through the third quarter, the Bulldogs leading it 26-18, and they strike, and this may have been the backbreaker of the night. Quarterback Clayton Moore finds Javon Bell. He's open, and he's going 70 yards. Nobody's going to catch him. He takes it all the way for pay dirt, and this gives Mississippi Gulf Coast a 33-18 lead. They never look back and go on to win this one 40-21.
Yeah, I was pleased with the athletic ability that I saw out there. A lot of guys flying around, a lot of playmaking ability. You know, the key for us right now is we got to improve in a lot of areas. But I was very pleased. I think we showed that we can run the football. We were able to complete some deep balls and throw the football around a little bit.
Well, I think it was a game of momentum. Obviously, mistakes happen. And, you know, we made more mistakes than they did, and they capitalized on them. The first half, I think the defense played 48 plays. At the end, we weathered the storm. They got an early trick play that worked for a touchdown. After that, I think our defense settled down to right there at the end. We just got a little tired, but get some momentum. The second half, we start getting some momentum back, and then we blew a couple coverages, and they took advantage of our mistakes. And that's basically what happened, you know, to the game.